Good afternoon, Mr. Chair and members of the committee. For the record, my name is Melanie Sachs, and I'm here to respectfully ask you to support CACR 22 Marcy's Law. 14 years ago, I was sexually assaulted in New Hampshire. I was 12 years old. 2 years after the assault, my case went to trial, just 2 months shy of my 15th birthday. Throughout the entire criminal justice process, I felt that my life was on hold and in complete control of the defense and my perpetrator. I had a great team to support me, but having constitutional rights that were on par with the man that sexually assaulted me would make a world of a difference in my case. I waited for 2 years after I reported the assault for the case to go to trial, and it did. I understand that these cases take time and that a defendant has important constitutional rights to due process, but the delay was due to not one, not two, but five uncontested postponements requested by the defense. As the victim, I had no constitutional rights to stand to dispute this. My statutory rights were not on the same level as my perpetrator's constitutional rights. Marcy's Law would provide victims with a constitutional right to proceedings that are free from unreasonable delay, as well as a prompt conclusion of a case. This would not have guaranteed that the court would have denied the defendant's request for a continuance, but it would have allowed the court to weigh each of our rights co-equally and to make a fair determination rather than having to automatically default to the defendant's constitutional right because it outweighed my statutory right. After the trial was over and my perpetrator had been convicted, I was struggling to heal and reclaim my life. Little did I know that my world would suddenly be turned upside down and I would feel victimized all over again. I was on vacation with my family in Rhode Island when I decided to check online to confirm that there had been no changes in the inmate status of my perpetrator at the time they were using the Vine program for victim notification. Something I did, I checked this regularly for peace of mind considering I was still living in fear and working to heal. To my surprise, I found out that my perpetrator had been released on parole. No one had notified me, not even the system that was supposed to be used to notify me. I didn't even know that he was eligible. I was not told that there would be a parole hearing, and I had no opportunity to speak to the parole board about my experience. I was shaken to the core. I felt like I was 12 years old all over again, frozen in fear and completely out of control of what was happening with regards to my safety. Could you imagine a situation where a defendant is not notified of a proceeding or given the opportunity to weigh in? Of course not. But unfortunately, this is my reality and the reality of far too many victims of crime. Due to the fact that I had only had statutory rights, there was nothing that could be done to right this wrong. There was no course of action and no next step. Had CACR 22 existed, had my rights to be notified, present, and heard been constitutional rather than statutory, I could have raised these rights and the parole board would have had to give me the opportunity to weigh in. There would be no guarantee that they would change their decision, and I understand that, but they would have had to listen, and I would have been able to move forward knowing that I did everything I could. I would have had the satisfaction of knowing that our criminal justice system cared about me, my safety, and my experience. I wouldn't have been ignored like a second-class citizen or forced to be on the outside looking in. I now work at a child advocacy center, and I'm an advocate for survivors. I've worked with countless survivors of child sexual abuse, sexual assault, and domestic violence. I've seen how the lack of basic enforceable rights can impact the trajectory of a victim's journey. I'm here to tell my story today to honor the courage of those who walked the road before me, to recognize those that are still feeling in silence, and in solidarity with those who are advocating alongside me now to bring meaningful rights to victims of crime in New Hampshire, my home state. Micah 6:8 says that I have been shown what is good and I have been required to act justly, love mercy, and walk humbly. Change is good. I urge you to join me in supporting CACR 22 to show survivors that their rights matter. Thank you, and thank you for your time.
What county did this happen?
Rockingham.